UJotv. This is Siyabonga, Gwala. Touchdown at the APK campus today. We are celebrating UJ World AIDS Day. And of course, a lot of festivities are going on, as you can see at the background. We're also in Heritage Month, and hope that you guys are having a brilliant time. Do not forget to hit us up on Facebook and on Twitter. Let us know how you're celebrating your Heritage Day. www.facebook.com/UJotv and UJotv on Twitter. It's going to be a fantastic day. I hope you guys can brace yourself, sit back, relax, and get ready.
My Africa is a clothing brand that fuses Evans with the Evans style, traditionally with the Evans style. And then we're trying to bring back our culture. We realize that most of the people and things that we wear inspired by Western culture. So what about Africa?
I see you are rocking a bucket hat. As you can see, no, it's still swag.
It's still swag.
You're fusing swag with Africa. So how important is that? How important is it for one to
The thing is that, like, you can always see that you're clothing represents who you are. So the way we dress, and when you go to the global market, they ask, what do you have in Africa? They say, Africa is what you want. It's our culture, it's our religion. So we just like to call upon everyone.
I want to know what inspired the
So from those ideas that I had, came up with the we're managing to create up what you want. We are on Instagram, on Facebook, we are on Twitter, and Instagram it's m_africa1, Facebook it's maafrica_sa, and then on Twitter it's m_africa1 as well. Okay, Evan tradition t-shirt. We fused the normal t-shirt with the special material, excuse me. And then the packing hats as well, shwe. They usually mix the shorts and the t-shirts, as you can see how I'm wearing. This is it, usually goes to 15. And then it's jean material, as you can see it. And then the hoodies, right now we're selling them for 210 since it's spring at the back that I'm wearing.
These are two very famous desserts in Taiwan, and this one is called York cake. Okay. So we got a yolk, egg yolk inside in the middle, but it's also a dessert. The black one is the red bean smash, so you can taste the sweet and salty texture and taste up in the same time.
Okay.
And this one is called
Taro.
Yeah,
taro cake.
Taro.
Yeah, it's sweet. The difference between these two is that this, like, you can taste salt and sweet at the same time, but this one you can only taste the sweet part.
Oh, I see. So I want to know, this is different. What is the main course? What do you guys usually have for the main course?
Oh, you mean meat? Meat meal?
Yes.
We got rice. Rice and noodles.
Oh, noodles.
Yes.
So you guys like rice and noodles?
Yeah.
All the time. We
don't
have that in Taiwan.
Yes.
Tell me, what's your favorite Chinese dish?
Beef noodles. We have heard beef noodles before. Noodles are really chewy, and the soup is really like smell really good because the beef inside, and the beef have lots of like vegetable, like carrot and like vegetable.
Yeah. I want to know, have you guys seen any African food?
Yeah, of course. But we don't really know the specific name of it, but you got lots of delicious meat. Yeah, you got so many kinds of cooking style. You got stewed, you got fried, you got those in the soup.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And I see you carrying tea here.
This is bubble tea.
Oh, bubble
tea. This is black tea and milk. Also, Pearl, do you see the black one?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe you should try this one.
Yeah. I'm a little hesitant.
It's really tasty. Trust me,
it's a great drink.
You won't regret.
I'm scared.
Don't be scared.
What is this?
What's this?
Yeah. Bubble tea.
We sell drink like this in Taiwan.
Cold, it doesn't have to be hot.
It can be hot.
Don't worry about this bubble. Don't worry about it. You mean?
Tastes good.
Yeah.
Tastes good. Thank you so much. I think I'll give myself a glass of water. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
Let's move on. So please tell us what is that?
Oh, so this is Bamumala in Nyanja. Bamumala in Zulu is Muhoto. Yeah.
So I want to know how different is it from the South African one or from the Zulu one?
To be honest, I haven't tried the South African one because I'm used to our stuff, but
You know it tastes good, right?
Yeah, it's very nice.
Okay, let's move along.
Yeah.
What is
and this? This is fish. It's normal fish, although it's brim.
Oh, I see.
It has been put in a stew kind of way. Uh-huh. There's potatoes and... but it's very nice.
Is it? Okay, so what kind of meal is it? Can you have it for supper, dinner?
Yeah, it's usually lunch and dinner.
Oh, okay, I see.
So it's like a delicacy back home.
Oh, I see. And I see you have some chicken fish here going on.
This is village chicken.
I see, this looks very nice.
Yeah, it's a strong one.
Yeah,
strong
the one. Best kind of chicken. Yeah.
So this is like the one that you keep in your backyard.
Yeah.
So it's meant to be, what exactly is it? It's meant to be the different.
How you cook it? You cook it for hours.
Yeah.
Because you want it obviously.
You want it to be fresh.
Yeah. Yeah. And then afterwards you fry the tomatoes and all them nandi things.
All them nandi things.
Absolutely fantastic. We're learning so many new cuisines.
Yeah.
We are currently eating a fish called tilapia.
Tilapia?
Yes, it's from Zambia.
Mm-hmm.
And we are also having tried. It's so delicious. Learning something new and it's just great.
I want to know, how is it different from the original South African tribe?
You know, everyone has their own spices, they add their own flair to it. So it's just great to have a new kind of dynamic.
I see your friend just can't stop digging inside. That's just how good it is.
So
tell me what
tastes really nice.
Yeah. I want
to
know.
What is it?
Yeah. So I want to know, how important is it for one to learn other different cultures and how they cook and how they bring about their food?
It's just because, you know, we are a multifaceted country, and we just learn about our different cultures. And there's definitely a market for everyone to come in. So yeah, it's just great. It's delicious.
So this food is from Malawi.
Honestly, I hate to be biased, but I'm proudly South African, and I had mushu, also known as Sam. Absolutely amazing, and I love it. It just tastes like home.
Nice. Thank you so much, guys. Eh? Enjoy the food. So right now I'm chilling with all people. Every day, you know, it's warm. Each day, I want to know, what's the importance of this?
I don't think World AIDS Day in itself is such an important day. I think every day is an important day. But I think this is just a reminder for us to put HIV/AIDS and sexual health in the front of our discussions. So talk about it. Be open about it. Be open about HIV. Be open about compromise. Be open about the discussions that sometimes are uncomfortable. And this is just a reminder for us to do it every single day.
Please tell us a little bit more about yourself.
What do you want to know? I mean, I'm 26 and I lost my parents to AIDS. I was then adopted, and later on when I was 19 I found out that I was born with AIDS. At the time I had a C1-2, which is really low. But thankfully, due to great medical care and great support system, my doctor family was very supportive, I was able to overcome that, and here I am today. So 26 years old with HIV.
Tell me about the experience. How did you react to when you found out?
It's a very difficult thing to be comfortable with, because HIV is still stigmatized a lot, especially in South Africa. And even for my family, for my biological family, it was very difficult for them to come up and say, actually, this is what your parents died from. So it took a very long time for me to find out what actually caused the death of my parents. But eventually they spoke to me and said, listen, my parents have HIV, of AIDS, and we think you might have two, you should get tested, and I got tested. And it was a mixture of shock, but also sadness, because I realized that they were going they went through so much, and they went through so much by themselves, and they didn't have support because of ignorance, because of not knowing better, because of bad healthcare, because of so many different factors. So it was, yeah, it was mixed emotions. I think, I mean, I like to be honest with people and say it's not easy. And as you see me standing in front of you today, it wasn't an easy journey. It took a lot of work, it took a lot of ups and downs, and I still go through them. But what you have to realize is that there is light at the end of the tunnel. HIV isn't what it used to be. It's no longer their symptoms, and so when you have it, there's no difference between you. As long as you take care of yourself emotionally, physically, mentally, then you can overcome it. So it's really about staying connected to yourself, staying true to yourself, and also being honest with yourself. So if you need time out, take that time out. If you need time to grieve, because yes, it's very sad, it's a part of your sexuality becomes lost in it. And so if you want to grieve that, that's okay, grieve that, you know? And there's no shame in that. And when you need support, ask for support. There's no shame in that either. You don't have to go through it.
Thank you so much for joining us.